protect the whole of justice.
And here we go.
Everybody, welcome to this week's Angry Geeks, the Tower of Power, too sweet to be sour, funky like a monkey. Yeah, I am the moneymaker. I am the one and only Lewis Perry. And with me always, my brother from another mother, the one and the only Rhode Island's very own Peter Griffin, a.k.a. Stevie Oaks. What's going on, brother? What? I can't hear it. What? Will you... What are you doing?
Okay, there we go. Sorry about that. Yeah, as Stewie likes to call me the fat man. So today, I'm the fat man. Hey, what's up, Sophia? How are you?
And Sophia. Oh, hold on. How you doing, Miss Sophia? How you doing? Yeah, he did it himself. He's got a new thing. Anyway, hey, we've been all week long, WrestleMania weekend. Of course, today marks the anniversary of the Ultimate Warrior's passing, so it was a big thing for the big guy. Anyway, we got a cool guest tonight, and congratulations to the American Nightmare, a.k.a. Cody Rhodes. Stevie, you and I had our picture taken with the newly crowned champion not too long
ago. Yes, we did,
we hung out with the champ.
And then right afterwards, he texted QT Marshall, who's his best friend, and was like, I just took a picture with Family Guy.
True
story, bro. That actually happened.
Really?
Yeah, because my buddy Chris Dizzle is actually friends with QT Marshall, and they were together at the time. And he was like, "Yeah, I just got a text from Cody. Just took a picture with Peter Griffin."
that was great. Immediately after Cody got the belt, I switched over you know, the cover photo of me, you with Cody, mm-hmm. and then a picture of me and Cody. I mean, that was great. And,
hey, what's up, you know, Ben? Next time, how are you?
Oh, hey, Ben is in the house. Hey, Benny, what's going on? And Sophia, once again. Oh, Sophia.
No, Sophia, we hope you're having a great day.
Yes, Sophia.
I don't know why, but when there's a microphone in front of my face, I have to get all nice and intimate with it. Like, hey, baby, how are you today?
Hey, that's my line. That's my line. Anyway, we got a guest in the back. Now, usually we have writers, we have artists, we have inkers, we have letterers, but this cat is the dude behind the scenes. He publishes them. He says yay or nay. He is the dude that this, like, you want to get your comic out there, this is the guy you got to talk to. He is one.
Eric Yakko?
No, it's not Eric Yakko. Eric Yakko sells the comics. He's the guy in the store to sell in the comics. That we'll talk about Eric a little bit later. But this is the guy. If you have an idea, he is one bad egg. Anyway, from Bad Egg Comics, the one and only Robert Meyers. Robert,
how are you today, buddy?
Doing great. How are you guys?
Amazing.
Amazing. You can't, I mean, WrestleMania the weekend, we just talked about it. Just simply amazing.
I'm still floating on it, man. It was such an amazing weekend. Nights.
You're a fan.
Fantastic.
Really?
Oh, yeah. Oh, good fan. Yeah.
Were you waiting for the glass to break?
Yeah. I don't know. I
thought both nights were fantastic. Stone Cold, and then
I was wondering. I was surprised. Really? But I thought it was great. Congrats to Cody. Excited to see what they do next and for tonight, etc. So,
well, my only thing. All right, I'm surprised Stevie didn't text me the second. No, they every time Macho was on screen, obviously people. You're happy. My only letdown, and our sponsor Eric Yakko from Ultimate Universe LLC. He had texted me, and one of our sister podcasts, Faces and Heels podcast, they both texted me at the same time. We had a group text going all weekend. Once Drew, I'm a huge Scottish Warrior fan. When that happened, they were like, and Lewis is crying in tears because he's happy. And Lewis is crying in tears because Drew just lost the belt.
Yeah.
That was the heist. They used to say that Seth stealing the belt from Roman with the cash in was the heist of the century. No, this was the heist of the century. This was like so
self-inflicted. All he had to do was kiss his wife, walk up the ramp, and he'd be champion today. He had to go and mess around.
Well, did you see the photo? My son was telling me about this. I guess Drew's family had took a picture of them flipping off the stadium. It's like that bad. I was like, wow. BB Butler says, hello, very excited for the Ultraverse. Yes. And awesome. You know what?
Thanks, BB.
Let's talk all about this. We got three new titles coming in, and Pagan Sheep comes in. It says, hello, everyone. Well, hello. Thank you for joining us. And thank you for subscribing. We saw that. The website told us.
Oh, fantastic.
Yes. Let's talk about Bad Egg Publishing. And for those of you that are interested, the people at Bad Egg are very gracious to give us and all our listeners and viewers a special code. Go on over there, Angry20. And what does that give them?
We're going to do a special, 20% off code for everybody watching the show, listening later, and everything else. We're excited to be here. We want to make it easy for people to read comics. That's the goal, right?
Yes, that's
more, what more people we want. Reading more comics. That's my goal.
And who doesn't love to save money? I know I do.
Yes. Yes. Yeah. All right. So let's talk Bad Egg Publishing. First, why the name Bad Egg? I love it.
So Bad Egg is a little bit of a deep cut. I don't know if we've ever said publicly where it's come from, but there was the whole brain trust. We were in Tampa. We were down there, had a whole meeting when we were basically one of the main goal of a weekend of meetings was to come up with the name, because we had a name we really liked. Couldn't get the trademarks for it. It was just would have been impossible to trademark. So we were like, okay, back to the drawing board. And we're sitting around and just spitballing ideas, throwing stuff around. We went down a bunch of rabbit holes, and as we were going down all the rabbit holes, people were like checking the registries, and it's like, no, can't do that, can't do this. And we got on a SpongeBob tangent, because who doesn't love SpongeBob? And so Bad Egg is a SpongeBob deep cut. He says, I don't want to be a bad egg. I want to be a happy noodle.
Okay. And,
happy noodle was taken. Bad egg was not. And I think it all came together just the right way. Yeah. So
where does your love for comics stem from?
Oh, boy.
And where do we want to start? Do we want to start with Plague Seeker? Do we want to start with Godslap? Where do you want to start?
We can start at the beginning. That's usually there. I'll do the abbreviated version of my comics origin story, if you will. My very first comic was an Archie Digest that I was a gift from my stepmother. Used to get like random furniture and have it refinished at this place where in this little shop where we lived. And the guy there had this Archie Digest, and we'd go in and drop off a chair, and I'd sit there and go through the Archie Digest. And he was like, hey, you can have it, take it. So that was step one. Then discovering the spinner rack at 7-Eleven, which then led to, wait, there's entire comic shops. And there was a comic shop in the town next to us. So that was my origin story in, I don't know, third, fourth grade, probably. So I've been reading comics pretty regularly since then. Worked at said same comic shop years later in high school. So I've also been the guy selling books. And then fast forward, we won't say how many years, but fast forward to 11 years ago now, and I was in grad school. I was in New York City, and I saw an internship posting at Valiant Entertainment, and I went, I didn't know Valiant Comics was around again. Jumped in, got an internship there. 8 months later, I was full time, and here we are, a few different companies, a few different roles down the road, and making comics and just having the time of my life. It's been amazing.
Now Valiant, you worked on some of the big name books there, if I'm not mistaken. Bloodshot. One stuck out to me. Turok,
Exo Manowar,
yes.
Ninjak, Harbinger. Those were the kind of the big flagship books there.
Yeah, was that the Bloodshot one with it was modeled with JDF as the as Bloodshot?
We did a web series at one point with JDF playing. Amazing, super fun to make, incredible cast and crew. You know, rest in peace, JDF. We miss him. Got to meet him at New York Comic Con. He came out, the whole cast from the web series came out and did a 2-day signing at New York Comic Con. I don't quite remember what year, we'll call it 2018. That was incredible. It was just absolutely amazing. And then, yeah, so from Valiant, I was at Oni Press for a few years. I worked on a lot of the licensed book at Oni. So I was working on the Rick and Morty comics and the Aggretsuko books, a few other things there. And then 2 years ago, I was working with Stephanie Phillips, who we love as she writes some of the best books out there right now. Stephanie called me and she said, hey, my brother's looking for someone to help set up a comic company. Would you be interested in talking to him? And I was like, well, yes, I would. And that call led to us getting started. You know, Bad Egg started with Godslap. That's the first book, which from the mind of Charlie / Moist Critical, as most folks on the internet know him. Charlie had an idea to make a book. They got the first issue up and moving, and I came on board, and we just published issue 5 in January. So we just wrapped the first story arc. Plague Seeker is Charlie's second book. So it's a completely separate. One is super anime manga influenced. On the outside, it looks like a cyberpunk book, but when you get into it, it is something very, very different. At its core, it is a fight comic. It is, it's a love letter to things like Dragon Ball, to things like One Punch Man, and everything in between.
Thank you, guys. You can see Plague Seeker right on the screen right now.
Yeah, and then Plague Seeker is Charlie's second book. It is a post-apocalyptic horror story. Incredible art. The the artist on the book is Vamkyr Trinell. He's a madman, just absolute genius. I don't know if there's any interior pages available to look at on the site. That's something actually we've been working on, but that's his cover. You can see the detail there. It's absolutely incredible. So the first issue of that came out, it went on pre-order 2 weeks ago, and it'll be start shipping probably next week. And I've actually got a copy of it here. I got an early version of it. So this is a... Right.
Guys, stop sharing. I'm
not sure how much you can tell there, but this is an 80-page single issue. Pretty
bring it up again, about. Robert.
Oh yeah. So cover, you kind of see the.
Wow.
It's a hefty boy, and I'll see if I can show some pages there without getting too spoilery. So you can see, like, these background things are just dumb. Yeah, there is. So that's still
it's phenomenal.
That's Plague Seeker, available still to order now. And then the next wave of books we have are with the legend Jacksepticeye. So those are the ALTRVERSE books. Jack came to us with a huge, big idea that we sat down, we had a big creative meeting. He and his creative partner Sophie have just created this amazing world, and it's all little seeds and background bits from videos over the years that he's posted on YouTube. And there's a whole universe that we're calling the ALTRVERSE because it's based on a series of characters that have become known as the Egos. So the first two ones that we're doing are Marvin the Magnificent, whose book is Void Silver, and the other one is the somewhat incredible Jackie Boy Man, whose book is the somewhat incredible Jackie Boy Man.
I had to read that title twice, not to interrupt you, and I'm sorry.
Yeah.
I had to read that title twice, you know, when our agent sent it over, and I was like reading it, and I was preparing our stuff, and I was like, what did that say? And I went back, Upside Down Bicycle, and I'm like, yeah, that did say that. Have a comment here I'm going to pull up, but that's okay, from BB.
Sure.
I imagine Plague Seeker is unrelated, but the marketing of this and the two ALTRVERSE issues coinciding, is it possible to see a crossover one day?
It's not impossible. We haven't gotten there yet, especially if they were in the same universe. They're about 1,000 years apart, so maybe. But we have talked about doing crossover books with different creators for sure. And I awesome. Think Jack's universe would be a great way to do that, because it's built as a very connected, very layered multiverse. So there are different characters in different timelines, and it would be fun to do something like that. It's certainly something we've talked about. We don't have any plans as of yet, but it's not something that we've said no. I like saying yes more than saying no. So.
All right, so now if you guys want these books, go to the Bad Egg Publishing website, and don't forget, you got Geeks 20, Angry 20. Yep. Put that in.
Angry 20.
That you can use it. That in. So excited.
So yes, the ALTRVERSE books go on pre-order on the 22nd, so we're 2 weeks away. And we'll be teasing little bits here and there. Really excited to get these books out. We did a prologue issue last year. In October, that was we called a zero issue, and it was 20 pages of story from each book. The first issues will be full 40 pages each. We do our books a little bigger than anybody else. We like to have a nice big chunk of story. You can really sit down and sink your teeth into it. It's and read it. It's fun.
Now, those of you in New England, Jetpack Comics, they're a carrier. Okay.
They are.
Those
of you, folks at Jetpack have been fantastic.
Yeah. Those of you in Illinois, you got Fantasy Books and Games. Okay. If New York, Anyone Comics, Bearded Dragon Comics and Games. And then you also have Everyone Comics and Collectibles. Guys, more stores need to pick these books up. I mean, we got to keep this. Yes, Sophia. Yes, I mean, yeah. I tell you, Jetpack Comics, Sophia. Yes, definitely. Jetpack Comics, Angry Geeks approved. You have to. I mean, if they're approved, yep. These guys are approved. Get these books.
Go for it. Sorry.
Yeah, no, it's not a problem. We've gotten a lot of comments coming in. Brain Leaker says, so excited for the Ultraverse. I think.
Parker, Robert's got some fans in the chat today.
Yes, good thing. Let's see. Parker says, I have a question about.
Been amazing.
Yes. Parker says he has a question about Jackie comments. I'm sorry if this is rude, but why did the artist for his comics change? Both artists are amazing. Yeah, I gotta agree. When you're in a comic and the artist changed halfway through a story arc, it changed the vibe of the book. Why? Why did that happen, Robert? Explain.
Sure. It's not that it's not all that complicated, to be honest. So the Zero issue, the prologue story for the Zero issue has been done by an artist named Connie Didoni. She's an Italian artist who we had second artist come in named Austin Beachel, who came in and honestly saved the day. Connie had not to open up an entire box, but Connie had some personal issues happen last year, and she just couldn't finish the book. We worked with her as best we could. We're still working with her. She's doing covers for us for the ongoing series. She's an incredible artist, and we'll find the right project to work on again. It was one of those things where one thing happened and then another thing happened, and we moved the schedule back as much as we could, and we just couldn't accommodate. Austin stepped in and helped us finish the book and kind of save the day. So huge thank you to him. When we sat down to get started on the issue one, Megan Huang, who's an up-and-coming artist, she's been doing some incredible work. She and I did an issue of Aggretsuko together about 2 years ago that was written by James Asmus. So James is working on the book, and he and I were talking about who could we bring in. Megan did the colors on the prologue issue, and her schedule wouldn't allow her to do pencils and inks. By the time we finished and started the next book, her schedule opened up. So it was kind of serendipity. It was like Connie couldn't continue on. Austin helped us, came in as like that amazing pinch hitter. And then Megan is now on the book. She's doing the pencils, inks, and colors for Jackie Boy. So it's a nice passing of the torch creatively, I think. The style changes a little going into issue one, but it's both books, both styles are wonderful. We're really happy with everything in there. But that's the short version, is life happens. And one of my goals with all of my creators is we want to be respectful of that, right? Like we had a call with a new artist that we're bringing on for an unnamed project the other day. And one of our things is we build our schedules to work with you. Like I'm not going to get on the phone and be like, I need 40 pages by next week. Like that's just not my MO. It happens in comics and nobody likes it, even when it, you know, from any end. So we're actively making sure we're building schedules that allow people to, you know, take a day off and have life and do all the things out there that are more fun than sitting at a desk.
That's very understandable, as Pagan Sheep said. DJ jumps in and says he just got here. He did not know that there was a live stream happening about the Ultraverse. Yay. And
welcome.
They're welcoming. Yeah, welcome. Thank you. Parker says, all right, I hope they're doing well. And it's amazing that an artist can have breaks and boundaries. How does Bad Egg go about choosing what property they want to bring into their universe? Question. And how do they go about choosing what artists or writers they want to work with? I mean, do you have auditions? Where do you find your stuff?
So it's two parts. So our specific mission is we're partnering with online creators who want to make comics. So Charlie Moist Critical, he's a founder of the company. He's part of the leadership and ownership of the company itself. We knew that Jack had this project out there. And so we went to his agent, and his agent actually came to us, and it was basically one meeting and we all just vibed so good that it came together. Past that, we've got Bad Egg is me and Michelle Abounditor, who's my publishing associate. Beyond us on the outside of the Bad Egg bubble, there's a whole company called Warren James. They're a merchandise company that works specifically with online creators. So we get fabulous support from them on business development, on operations, on e-commerce. So our websites, they're experts at e-commerce and distribution and all of that. So all of that is stuff that I don't have to stress about because I've got an incredible team working on it. So, you know, we're partnering with creators that are already in the Warren James family for merch. And then basically once we announced Charlie's books and then Jacksepticeye's books, and then the books that are coming out right after this, we haven't quite talked about. Every time we have an announcement, we get people coming to us at this point, knocking on the door saying, "Hey, love comics, want to work with you guys." And then once we get those people, you know, we get creators in the family, casting the books, getting people on board on the comic side is relying on, you know, my network, my Rolodex, as it were, Michelle's network and Rolodex. Some of it is people that we just want to work with. Some of it is people that have expressed, like, you know, I'll get in touch with an artist and be like, "Oh, I watch Jack's stuff in the studio all the time. I'd love to do a cover," or "I'd love to, you know, Charlie's one of my favorite people to watch. I'd love to do a cover or interiors, et cetera." So it's been really fun. It's been really organic on that side. And then, yeah, I guess, you know, the other kind of third of it is we're constantly looking for new folks to bring in. Both established artists, writers, as well as new artists and writers. Susie Blake, who's working on, who's working on Void Silver, is an artist I did a portfolio review for two or three years ago. And she did a cover for me for Rick and Morty and a cover for me for Regretsico. And we've kept in touch. And so when this project came in, she was my first pick, and luckily it worked out. She's also local to Fantasy Books and Games, and they will be doing some signings there once the next issues come out. So,
very, very impressive. Robert Gill, huge shout out. Owner of Meet So Horny, Meet So Horny Nation, one of our show sponsors, nice. and the owner of Real Vibe TV. Thank you for joining in, awesome. Boss. Thank you very much. Another question coming in from the DJ. DJ says, "I have a friend who's currently going to SCAD and wanting to get into the industry and is a huge fan of the Ultraverse. How can he go about getting in touch with Bad Egg?"
If it's to reviewing a portfolio, send it to us on the website formerly known as Twitter. I refuse to call it the other. Sorry, I just can't do it. You know, you can reach out to us at support@badegg.co. That's probably the best way to, we don't have a dedicated like portfolio line.
Thanks, guys.
Yeah, thank you. And we're not taking submissions for publishing right now, but always looking at portfolios for sure.
Okay. When would submissions be up? Do you have any ETA?
At the moment, we're going to stick with the model that we're rolling with. So we're partnering online creators with comic creators to make projects come to life. At some point, I'd love to, expand our publishing line to include more traditional creator owned books. And, we have talked about maybe trying to pick up some like licensed books, licensing like a video game X. We'll do the comic for, but we're just not there yet. You know, it's a small team. Two, we want to get a little more ground underneath us before we start building out too big.
All right. DJ says, "All right. Thank you. We'll let them know." All right. Three big books coming out: Void Silver, Plague Seeker, and Jackie. Which of those three books are you most excited for?
You're asking me to pick a child, Lewis.
I am a big child. Come on. what are you most excited for?
Yeah. I love all my children equally, as they say. I love all of our books pretty equally as well.
Except Meg.
I think it's maybe because I've been working on it a little closer is probably Void Silver. But I can't, it's like 1A, 1B, 1C. They're all my, you know, Plague Seeker. They're all so different, which I really love. So it's like Plague Seeker is kind of existential post-apocalyptic horror, right? And it's done. We've got stuff in that book that you've not seen thematically, or even like, it's not zombies in the future. It's a whole different thing. Mm-hmm. I love Void Silver because it takes a thing that we all kind of, I think, enjoy, which is that, you know, what if magic was real? And then puts
whoa,
it in
whoa, 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 whoa. What do you mean it's not real? Of course it's real.
I meant, what if magic was real and recognized publicly?
Oh, okay.
So it's, all right. Yeah. Thank you. So it's a really fun spin on that. And the way it loops into the greater ego's mythos is incredible. And then I love Jackie Boy. He's just this guy, right? He's just this little guy who wants to, like, he wants to have a life. He wants to have friends. He wants to have fun. And he kind of keeps stumbling when he gets there, but every time he picks himself up and he just keeps going. The book's got a real kind of 60s Marvel vibe, which I really love. 60s Marvel vibe through a manga lens is kind of the best way to put it.
I can see that through the cover. Okay. The upside down bicycle. I can definitely see that. All right. Ben Hellman wants to know, how was it working for Oni Press?
It was great. Some incredible people at Oni. You know, I was there in a very kind of difficult period. I accepted a position with Oni in February of 2020 and moved from Brooklyn to Portland in March of 2020. Oof. So we all know what that looks like going forward.
Yes.
But it was a lot of fun. Just from like the books I got to work on, like I got to work on Rick and Morty. I got to work on Gudetama. Like I forgot, love Gudetama. For just the silliest reason, it's an egg, right? It's an egg who has existential dread. How can that not be fun? And it was a great crew of people. So you know, and I'm still friendly with the folks there. Like Hunter Goranson, who's the president and publisher, is the person who hired me at Valiant. So like it all, I love how small comics is, a small world, and it's nice being friendly and connected with people that are all across the spectrum. So,
All right. Now we have a gazillion more questions coming up about Jackie.
I just want to say, I love how Robert went through all his comics trying to figure out which one is his favorite, kind of like a presidential town hall. Just can't commit to one answer. Gotta go with all of them.
Yeah. Well, I like them all for different reasons. And then hopefully other people will like them all for different reasons too.
Okay, so
talk about Godslap. I mean, we got.
Yeah, I know, and I want to. Hold on one second. Foxcat Gameplay says, "I'm going to be completely honest. I don't want Jack to quit YouTube, but I know that he has to." Pagan Sheep comes back and says, "Jackie has so much passion to keep going. It's amazing." LOL. And then DJ comes back and says, "I love all the boys so much." And BB, is there a price range you could provide? Are there limited edition items? That can all be found on the website. Am I correct?
Correct, yeah. But I'm happy to answer as well. We're doing all of our books on a pre-order setup. So it's very similar to a comic shop ordering out of previews and then going to the publisher and saying, we want X many books. So we're doing the same thing. We do a pre-order, the books ship. Once we get the pre-order number, we go to print. We always print extra so that people who missed the pre-order can get their books, etc. What we are doing is a special edition book just in the pre-order window. So that first week and a day of the pre-order, for ALTRVERSE Zero, we did like a foil cover, which was super fun. We're doing a foil cover for Plague Seeker and the number ones for ALTRVERSE next week or 2 weeks from now. Pricing, our base pricing for the books is $15. The limited edition books are a little bit more, just depending on kind of how fancy it is. So they've been 20, or sorry, they've been 30, which will be, you know, we'll continue to evaluate things as we go. Books are a little higher. I can, Lewis, I can see you. But we're publishing, we're trying to put the books out quarterly, and they're 40 pages and rather than 20 pages, which is normally what you're going to get from a, I don't know, your average Marvel or DC book is like 20, 24 pages these days. So we're doing a full 40 page plus, like Plague Seeker number one is 80 pages. Some of the Godslap books have been 44, 48 pages. So.
But you could see me what I wasn't.
No, I'm just kidding.
Well, all right. I was looking at some other comments. Starlit Roses comes in and says, Marvin and Jackie are my favorites. I'm excited for their stories. Now, we already talked about this early, but I want to answer this comment again. This question we answered early. I wonder if they're what their paths would end up crossing. It sounds like a very wanted question, so I wanted to bring that
up. For sure. I mean, so the I'm sure a lot of the folks in the chat know more a lot about the Egos. There are more than just these two characters. These two really were the ones we sat down and looked at all the different characters that Jack has. These were the two that made most sense to start with comics. Are they ever going to meet? I think they kind of have to at some point.
All right, let's.
When's that going to be? I have to keep that close to my heart for now, but I think they kind of have to.
All right, let's talk the granddaddy of them all. Let's talk what started it all, Godslap.
Sure. Godslap is Charlie's brainchild. The apocryphal story is he called his business partner / manager / best friend / the tall guy in his videos, Matt. He called Matt apparently on Christmas Eve and was like, I want to make comics. I've got an idea. And then kept Matt on the phone. Matt's at his now wife's house, you know, family's house. He's like, Charlie, it's Christmas Eve. Can we talk about this? Or maybe it was Christmas Day. I could get it wrong. But basically, they got back from holidays, started work on it. Matt's sister is Stephanie. And so she wrote the first script, got them set up with an artist and a letterer. Kind of walk them through the basics of it. And that's when I came on board as we were getting ready for issue two. Godslap is, it's a testament to all things Charlie loves. It's slap fighting. I listed a bunch of manga and anime influences, but it's One Punch Man. It's JoJo's Bizarre Adventure. It's One Piece. It's all of these things that we love. But with his own very unique, very really incredible detailed spin on it. So Charlie and Matt, Danny and Jackson all kind of came up with the universe. I came in, like I said, around issue two, and we really just got to work on taking it, making it, you know, this big thing. Stephanie was so, she got the first one done and up and running, and she was like, I'm too busy. Like, I just can't keep, she's writing so many books at Marvel, and she was on, you know, the Harley Quinn thing, I think it only just started, plus Grimm and all the other great stuff she's doing. So I reached out to Aubrey Sitterson, of No One Left to Fight and, Worst Dudes and a bunch of other great comics. Aubrey and I have been friends for years and never got to work together. And I was like, at its core, this is a fight comic. If there's one person I know who can write a fight comic, it's fucking Aubrey Sitterson. And Aubrey came in and he looked at this thing and we had like two or three phone calls. Cause it was like, I'm like, I know it's a little different. It's like a licensed thing, but it's not licensed. It's a little creator owned, but you're going to be free. And it's all these little weird pieces. And so I sent him the materials and he wrote me back and he came back. He's like, you just should have told me it was a fight comic. And I was like, it's a fight comic. And so Aubrey came on, and so he and Charlie and Jackson have been working really closely on the writing for issues, you know, two through five. We've got issue six in the hopper right now. And then the artist on the book, I'd be remiss if I didn't talk about Ricardo. Ricardo Jaime is incredible. Again, not someone I had worked with, but he's amazing. He's been so much fun to work with. He's passionate about comics in every way, shape, or form. And I just thrilled every time he sends in a new batch of pages. It's mind blowing. It just, every single one just elevates off the prior page. So it's a beautiful book. Ricardo's got this really fun, like 90s vibe, which I think we all can probably align with to a degree. And then the book's black and white, with pops of color that Ricardo puts in for special effects and for mostly for blood. So like I said, issue 5 came out in January. We're going to do a collected edition this summer, and we'll launch issue 6 alongside that collected edition. So you can get caught up and buy the new issue all in the same time.
Awesome. I think we have somebody here that owes you some money. I'm not sure if I should post this comment, but Parker says, is it hard to send out the comics? I accidentally got sent two of the Void Silver comics when they first got released. I'm not complaining. I love the covers. I think you should invoice
them with a friend. That'd be my. I think that's the universe saying you make a new fan.
Yeah, there you go. Parker, you are the winner of the no prize. You got the book.
Got it.
There you go.
See a need, fill a need.
Don't you dare use the code. And Parker says, wait.
Hey, whoa.
Did you?
Lois, all right, so this isn't my Batman cup.
We're getting that is amazing laughing my ass off. And Parker, no, please. Well, at least you did enjoy the book. And did you give it away? Make a new fan. That's what this is all about. Spread the word and get it. Speaking of spreading the word, it is time for this
week's my God.
Question. Yeah, it's question of the week. And speaking of LCSs, question of the week is brought to you by Alternate Universe LLC in Hartford and New Haven. Eric awesome. Yacko, if you want your comics, contact Eric Yacko, Alternate Universe. Make sure you ask him to mail your comics. He will do a sub for you. He will do a pull for you. Mail to them. Mail you them flat, even back issues. Contact him. He'll look in through one of his two stores and make sure he gets those back issues for you. They are Angry Geeks approved, and they'll even be more approved if they get the Alterverse in his store. Mm-hmm. And first question, are you ready, Robert?
I'm ready.
All right. What's the oddest license plate or sticker you've ever seen on someone's car?
Oh, I like
that's pretty tame. That's pretty tame.
That's pretty tame. I will say my favorite bumper sticker I've ever seen was on the back of a woman's car that said, "Let go of my ears. I know what I'm doing."
That's awesome.
Stevie,
saw that in San Diego a long time ago.
Lois,
what is the oddest license plate you've ever seen?
It wasn't a license plate; it was more of a bumper sticker. But it was one that says, "I'm not perfect, but I'm Christian, so I'm forgiven."
All right, let's see. We're getting comments. Foxcap Gaming says, "Cats have some kind of power over us." Pagan says, cats are powerful. High Quality says, I wish cats were real. And Fox Cat says, no kidding. Okay. Oh, I believe you guys. I do.
Does anybody ever realize why cats are so angry though? It's because, well, they're the perfect gods. They're God's perfect killing machines, but you know, they weigh about 5 pounds. So we pick them up and hug them.
Yeah. Next
question. Who is the biggest Karen you know?
Ooh. Oh, we can't call people out like this.
Ooh, yeah. Robert, who is the biggest Karen you know?
Can I change biggest to best?
Sure. You are the guest. What? You can do it. Who is the biggest?
My dad's wife is named Karen, and she is fantastic.
Oh my God. Oh, that.
How's that?
I know. I'm gonna play Stevie! Stevie!
Oh, man. Who's the biggest Karen I know?
Oh, Fox Cat Gameplay says my mother.
Wow, you know, Fox Cat came in and stole this from me, but I was actually my mom's dead, so I can't say her, but my mother-in-law.
Okay. Yeah, fair enough. Okay.
We want to thank your house tonight, Lewis.
Yeah, I know. I want to thank Alternate Universe for paying the bills and thank them. Make sure you go down and see Eric and the boys every Wednesday for free for New Comic Book Day. Yes.
I want to chime in on the chat real quick.
Okay.
People are talking about Higgins, which is Marvin's cat. Higgins is based on two real cats, the writer and the artist's cat. So the Higgins we see in the book is an amalgamation of two real cats, one of whom is named Higgins.
Okay, and hold on one second. We are getting way out of control. Guys, slow down. All right. Parker says that one blah dude in the Ultraverse is a huge, huge Karen. Foxcat says, I'm not kidding either. She put up a sign for Halloween sing, and I... And one kid, you do not, we have, what? And one kid, you do not, we do not have candy. Okay. All right. Oh, my God. No, you can't type it. I can't. Yeah. And I can't read. And, what time
Big
is
bong.
It? Oh,
Big bong.
It is time for a game. Are you guys ready to play a game? Audience, are you guys ready to sit back and play a game? Robert? Make sure before we start playing the game that you guys go to the Bad Egg website, get your 20% off, and get these books before they run out, because they will run out. I'm hoping that they run out.
We did. We just did a second printing on ALTRVERSE Zero and Godslap Number One that we have in stock, but we did the second print there, and we are assuming that the pre-order for Void Silver and Jackie Boy Number One are just going to be huge. But our mission is sort of the main covers we will keep in stock / do second, third, fourth printings as needed. The variants are always going to be limited, and we will not reprint any of the variant covers.
Okay. Now, since there's only three of us tonight, I'm going to remove two stacks, or maybe not. I don't know. Put Optimus Prime down.
I am Optimus Prime.
Now, before me, I have. We'll play five stacks of cards. We have 10 minutes left on the clock on the show. Robert, you were. Explain the rules of the game. You get to go first. Okay. You get to go first. Now, granted, you are. You get to go first, and you don't know me. You don't know Stevie, so this is a guessing game.
Can I answer Sophia real quick?
Yes.
Autobots, transform and roll out.
And yes, Sophia told. Okay, so, Robert, 1, 2, 3, 4, or 5? Pick a number.
5.
5. 1, 2, 3, or 4?
2.
And pick Stevie or I.
Stevie.
Hey, how are
Stevie?
You?
Stevie. Oh, this could be either way. Robert, did Stevie go trick-or-treating last year?
Yes.
No.
No! Oh!
I haven't been trick-or-treating since I was 14 years old.
Yeah, probably the same.
But... Stevie, 1, 2, 3, or 4, or 5?
Let's go 4.
4. Stevie? 1, 2, 3, 4.
Let's go 3.
1, 2, and 3. Robert or myself?
I'll return the favor. Let's go Robert.
Stevie.
Yes.
Stevie, can Robert swallow multiple pills at a time?
You know, I don't want to say Robert looks like a swallower, but, I'll go with you.
Robert.
That's a yes. It confounds my girlfriend on a daily, nightly basis, but yes.
All right. Steve. Stevie, go again. You got 1 point. One, two,
all
three,
right,
four,
I'll go
five.
Number one.
One, one, two, three, or four?
One.
One. And Robert or I?
I'll go Lewis this time. Why not?
This is easy. Uh-huh. Has Lewis ever been in a fist fight?
Yeah.
Correct. Stevie, one, two, three, four, or five?
Let's go two.
Two. And a Parker says, oh my God, they should make a Higgins plush. One, two, three, or four?
Four.
Parker, I'm with you.
And is it myself or is
yeah,
it
I'll Robert? Rotate. I'll rotate to Robert.
Robert, does Robert own an electronic toothbrush?
No, I'll say he goes. I'll say he goes old school.
He's right.
Wow, Stevie is rocking it tonight with 3 points. Stevie, go again. One, two, three, four, or five.
One.
One. One or two.
One
or three. One. And
Lewis.
Can Lewis name the hospital he was born in?
I would hope so.
Yes, I can. Norwalk Hospital. I was actually Dr. John D. Burke. I was the last baby that he brought into this world because I was too hot to handle and I was too cold to hold. Okay.
So we call it Ghostbusters and now it's in control?
Oh, you shut up. All right, Stevie, one, two, three, four, five?
Two.
Two? One, two, or three?
Three.
Robert or me?
We'll go to Robert.
Has Robert ever hitchhiked?
Out of necessity, I'll say yes.
Robert?
I don't think I have. I'm going to say no.
Fair enough.
I'm going to say no.
You never broke down on the side
been,
of the road.
There have been those long nights where we've talked about hitchhiking and then thought better of it.
Yeah.
All right, Robert, yeah, it's your turn.
All right.
All right. One, go. Two, three, four, five.
Let's go three.
One, two, three. And it's one, two, three, or four.
Let's go one.
One. And Stevie or myself?
Let's go Lewis. Switch around.
Has Lewis ever had phone sex?
Yes.
He's got multiple baby mamas. I would hope so.
Robert, you go again. 1 point for Robert on the board. Oh, boy. And... yes, and we're getting comments in. Yeah, no, we'll be quiet about that. Okay, so one, two, three, four, or five, Robert?
Four.
One, two, three, four. One, two, or three?
Two.
Okay.
Four, two.
Solid.
Stevie,
we'll stick with Lewis.
Or, okay. Ooh. Did Lewis send out holiday cards last year? That's okay. Did Lewis send out holiday cards last year?
I'm going to say Lewis planned on it, thought about it a lot, didn't get it done, thought about it really hard around New Year's, and then said, fuck it, I'm going to wait till next year.
Incorrect. Actually, I don't know. This is a trick question because I didn't technically did it. My wife did it, but put my name on it. So that would that be as I did do it or I didn't do it?
I would count that. I think you could.
I would give. All right, let's give it there. Let's give it to him. Okay.
All right. So I just want to say for follow up on this question though is where was mine?
Oh.
Anyway, Robert.
I thought we were close.
All right, we're getting some more questions about the book, so we're gonna have one more round of this really quick, and then we're gonna get back to the book. We only have 6 minutes left, because people are just jamming with these questions. And I want to get back.
Yeah,
to
it's the great. Love but it.
All right. You want to call the game, Stevie? You won. We'll call the game, and let's get back to the questions because people are watching. Yeah, let's just go with it. Okay, let's get back.
I'm a winner, Lois. I'm a winner.
Okay, so we got some spoilers coming up. Parker says he thinks that JJ and Henrik are going to be the next ego to show up in the comics, as they've been missing in action. And Dapper says, we've already seen that most likely anti-Henrik, I'm suspicious of. I have a feeling we have already spotted him. Max Trash, I think Henrik will probably be most likely to be first seen out of the egos. And Brian Leaker, wow, this is like amazing, guys. Thank you so much. Was wondering if there's ever going to be a comics based around the other egos. And Parker comes back and says, I think we got the same theory as you, Dapper. And BB says, if 100% we saw Henrik already and caused this stuff to happen. Mm. Now, do you want to...
This is the stuff okay. I love.
There you go. And while we were playing a game, making a fool out of me in phone sex, and these guys are true geeks and nerds, and this is something else. I mean, this is what we're all about. These questions were just coming up through, and they were just like nerding out here. And of course, Pagan says, oh my goodness, that must have been about the phone sex. And Foxcat says, Annie Comet. Mm-hmm. And then we have, I wonder if a bad egg would ever do Ultraverse merchandise like plushies. And that's where we came with it. Higgins plushie. Sure. New comments again.
Oh my God, they should make a Higgins buggy plushie.
Yes. Will there ever be Ultraverse like plushie or figures? And Pagan says, we're all it, nerds Pagan. For Jack. There you go. I couldn't read
it. So, okay. Let's see. I say kind of earlier on, we had our initial creative call with Jack was all the characters that he had created, all the Egos characters and other characters. And these are the two we thought would be the best place to start. So will we see other characters? I cannot confirm or deny, but I will say stay tuned / we want to make a lot of books. We want to keep these running because we're having so much fun with it. So the first two series, Void Silver, Jackie Boy Man, are going to be 5 issues each. What we do after that is stay tuned. And then as far as the plush and merch go, 100%, it's a thing we want to do. Bad Egg is a sister company to a fantastic merch brand who do incredible plushies. If you've seen the plushies for the creators like Crew and Daco, those are all Warren James creations. So yes, I can't say exactly when, but there is a really big pop culture Comic-Con in the fall.
Rhode Island?
Bigger.
Nothing bigger than Rhode Island.
This is true. But there might have but I'm just saying, keep an ear out for things that happen, say, in the fall on the East Coast.
Something like New York Comic Con.
Rhode Island. Okay, Rhode Island Comic Con.
We're the biggest show in the smallest state.
Yes.
It's a good show. No, I've not been. I've tried to go a bunch of times actually when I lived in New York. I've got friends who was like, let's go for the weekend, and then something would happen. But I've heard it's a great show.
It is a great show. Yeah, it is fantastic. Not just saying that because I work there. I'm just saying because from my heart, Rhode Island and Sophia. It.
That's right, Sophia. I love RICC. In fact, we should make t-shirts now. I love RICC.com for all your I love RICC t-shirt needs.
Perfect.
We should do that, definitely. I love RICC for sure. Anyway.
Go ahead.
No, definitely. Oh. Bring Bad Egg to RICC. Contact.
We're talking about it's this year's. It's almost like it's April. Shit. It almost feels like too late, but we're going to do some shows towards the end of the year. And then next year we'll be hitting the road a bit. But you can catch Michelle, Abounditor, my publishing associate. She will be at a bunch of fan expo shows over the summer. She's already done a few. I think she's at Cleveland, the Cleveland show this coming weekend. And she usually goes out to the shows with some sort of Bad Egg goodies with her. So find her at the show. She's got blue hair. She's usually hanging around Artist Alley. And then we have some other, we'll have more news on some of the bigger conventions and places where we want to set up at. Like I said, it may not be this year where we do an official booth, but next year is really the goal for that. Taking a lot of cues from things that, like how we operated at Valiant and things I've just learned, you know, doing this for long enough, is you don't want to show up and be the smallest table at the biggest show. And you know what I mean? You want to show up and come in strong. So, but we have some definite plans for it, because I love getting out to conventions. It's something I've missed for the last few years. So,
absolutely. Robert, we're out of time. I want to thank you for being on with us.
Yeah,
everybody, make sure you go over to the website. Okay.
And that, if I can just say,
right here. Yes.
Tell your local comic shop to get a hold of us, retailers@badegg.co. We want to be in more stores. We offer pretty great terms. And we'll be in the Diamond catalog soon.
So there you go. If Diamond, right there, go to that website. Yeah. Contact Robert and the guys. If you're having trouble, you can't get there, contact me, contact Stevie, contact Jamie, contact one of us. We'll get you in contact with Robert and the guys. You know where to find me. You know where to find Stevie. Every Monday night, we're right here. Stevie is on his TikTok, all the Peter Griffin stuff. Go and find him. Find Robert. Get these books. Remember, Angry 20.
Thanks, okay? Guys.
Thank you, guys. Yes. Thank you guys for always joining in, clicking that bell, getting the notifications. Thank you so much from the bottom of my heart. You're all Angry Geeks approved. We'll see you guys here next week. We got another amazing guest coming up all through April, all the way into May. We're going to be live on location for Free Comic Book Day. We'll see you guys soon.